Hi everyone, it's Nonna Grace and I'm from Western New York. Today was a chicken day. I went outside and I checked, first of all, the hen that I thought was Broody wasn't Broody. She happened to be sitting on some eggs the other day, but this morning when I went to see, because I was going to mark them, and the hen was not on the eggs, and when I touched them, they were ice cold. So apparently she's not sitting on them, so she's not Broody. That's why she didn't puff up and try to snap at me. But when I went in later that day, I thought, why is that hen still in that box? And, well, before that, I got to back up a little bit because I did something before that. I wanted to clean out their house. I took the old wood chips out and the poop out and put new fresh wood chips in. And I noticed while I was doing that, the one hen just stayed in the little nesting box. And usually when you're scraping around and digging out, they get up to see what you're doing because they're very curious. Well, she stayed there. And when I was done, I went and looked at her. And she had been either, I don't know if it was one of the other hens or maybe when the rooster was trying to mate with her, her cone on the top of her head was all bloody. So I picked her up. She was really sweet. Brought her in the house, cleaned her off. I put bag balm on it. I don't have that stuff that you spray on the birds. I should get some because it's supposed to give it a purple color, a color that they don't like to look at, and put it on her. And then I put some water in there, and she was very thirsty, and I put some food in there. And then I hung a dog gate across the door because I want her to be able to see, and I want everybody to be able to see her. I don't want her to be alienated because you have to introduce them back in if they don't see each other. I think that they're a different bird that hasn't been around, where I want them to be able to see her, but they will just leave her alone. And when I saw her later, when I went to take the food out, because I locked the birds in already, and when I went to take the food out, her head looked much better. So the bag balm was making it heal. I think they heal rather fast, because even when the roosters were in a fight and they looked, that one looked really bad, the next day you couldn't even tell that he had a fight. So I think they heal rather fast, which is a good thing. I also had a question about, because when I was talking about if they were broody, that, you know, the little chicks would be, it would be chillier. They would spend a lot of time underneath their mom. Someone had mentioned wanting to know if there was extra heat put in the hen house. That would make them get sick if I put extra heat in. The birds actually are like wearing heavy, heavy, heavy down coats. In fact, in the summer, the breed that I have find it really hard to deal with the heat. They walk around with their mouth opened, gapped, because like a dog, how it pants to release the heat through its mouth, the chickens do the same thing. And then you will see them with their wings, instead of close to their bodies, they'll have them spread out, trying to get more air like underneath their wings, so that they can cool their bodies down. They're really more for cold weather. In fact, it's not that cold out today, and they were all sleeping on the outside of the chicken house. They weren't even inside the little chicken house. They were out in the enclosed run because it's too warm. If they all get inside the little house, their heat, they produce a lot of heat, and that heat makes them too warm, and then they can't cool down. So they're on the outside. In fact, some of them sleep on the roof of the little house. So they're really outside. And they were sleeping out there when it was really cold outside. But apparently they like it better. They sit on their feet to keep their feet warm. And they tuck their heads under their wings so that their little crowns on their heads don't freeze. And this is how they sleep and they stay warm. I think that was everything I wanted to say. I think so. I did a lot of talking there. A lot of fast talking. I liked that my mic stand, it did, you know, when I look at the thumbnail. It did look like a gun. It's not a gun, though. And I was thinking, you know, I could put rubber bands. I could use rubber bands on that and just kind of stretch the rubber band and pa-ting, and I could see it as a rubber band shooter. Like instead of a slingshot, a rubber band shooter. We used to have rubber band fights. I don't know if you ever had rubber band fights where you clicked it onto your finger and you put the rubber band around the hand and put it on the finger. And then when you release the pinky, the rubber band would fly. We used to do that. We had, in the living room, we used to have rubber band hide behind the chair and bing. And because there was far enough a distance, it didn't really hurt. So that's it. And or you could put them on your finger and pull and snap it. The boys used to do that too sometimes, but I like to wrap it around my hand and have the rubber band fight. Well, that's it for today. I'm going off onto a silliness. So instead of doing that, we're going to say goodbye, and I'll talk to y'all again tomorrow. Bye.